Hello, welcome to Hank's Maker Mentor. My name is Ruth. The Cricut Mug Press is now available online and in stores when they can keep it in stock. Design Space has a lot of projects that are ready to make or ready for you to add a name or personalize just a little bit and then make them. But what about if you want a design that is entirely your own? There is a free project that allows you to design your own cut projects, and then another one that allows you to design your own drawn designs to use with the infusible ink pens and markers. I'm going to be using Design Space on my iPad. The same ideas will apply with the desktop and Android version of Design Space, but there are some differences in what features are available. When I first opened Design Space, this is what shows on my screen. If you're not here, you'll want to go ahead and click on Home and make sure you are in all categories. In the search bar, go ahead and type in mug design. It'll bring up a whole bunch of the pre-done mug designs as well, but today we want this mug design setup. This is the one if you're using the infusible ink transfer sheets. So you want to go ahead and click on that. Next, you'll need to choose what size mug and what edge style you want. There are the small 12-ounce mugs and the large 15-ounce mugs. You've got the 5 different edge styles: straight, ripped, scalloped, wavy, and zigzag. I don't care what edge I have on this one since it won't actually be included in my design. I do know I want it on the 15-ounce mug, so I'm going to select one of these large designs. Then I'm going to go ahead and click Customize. Here on the canvas, you'll see 3 different layers, and I'm going to open up the Layers panel to make it a little bit easier to tell which one's which. The red draw layer tells you to hide it before you cut. The purpose of it is to allow you to see where on the mug your design is going to be relative to the handle. If you want it directly opposite the handle, you'll set it up in this area. If you want it facing both directions but centered when you hold it, you can set them up in these areas, whatever works best for you. The teal design is just the default color. That is what the ink is going to be. So this is where I've got the scalloped edges. If you had chosen ripped or one of the other ones, you'd see those on this one too. And then this very bottom one is designed to cut through not just the layer of the transfer sheet of the ink, but also of the backing on it, to allow the backing to be the right size so you don't have to manually cut it down to size to get it to fit on the mug. It'll actually run 2 passes around that section to make sure it cuts all the way through. So I'm going to hide the Layers panel by just clicking on the Layers word again. So I'm going to zoom out just a little bit, and I'm going to go ahead and come into Images, and you can browse through, you can look for the different categories. I know that I want a wolf on mine, so I'm going to type in wolf and click search. And there's a whole bunch of designs. I know that most of these are not what I'm looking for, so I'm going to go into filters and I'm going to find the one I've already purchased and the one I uploaded. And to do that, very quickly, you go into filters and you click ownership. And then you select uploaded, purchased, and I do free as well, and then I click done. These are the 2 designs I wanted, so I'm going to select both of them. You'll see them show up at the very bottom to let you know what's going to be inserted, and then I'm going to click insert to finish getting them on the canvas. I do need to make sure I go and resize these. You want to make sure they're not too big. About 3 inches allows you to see the entire design on the size of your mug. Since I want the wolves out of the ink instead of being the negative space, I'm going to click on one of the wolves, hold it down till it selects it, and then do the same thing. Hold down on the other one until it selects both of them. And then I want to go into Actions and click Attach. I want to come into this draw layer and I want to hide it. And same thing with the teal layer. I want to hide it as well. Once you have everything where you want to select everything, go back into actions, and then click attach. This will attach your design to the backing layer. Here in my layers panel, I detached that background piece from the actual design. I want to show you that if you forget to attach them, this is what you're going to see. And it'll let you know that you need to go back to your canvas and go ahead and select them all. Go into actions. And even just clicking group won't solve it. You need to go in and you need to make sure you click attach. Because then when you go to make it, they are together and they're going to be lined up the way you designed them on your canvas. I hope it was helpful to see how to use attach to design your own mugs to use with your Cricut mug press. Thanks for watching. If you have more questions about this, go ahead and check out my other videos. If this has gotten you excited to try more with Infusible Ink, go ahead and check out my Infusible Ink playlist right here. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye.